Okay, this is my second day of my urine fast. I know. This is the crazy girl again who is drinking her pee pee all the time. Not eating anything, just drinking that nasty thing and distilled water. And actually, I've been thinking this is how the majority of people watching the video will probably think, right? And I haven't done any introduction about the urine therapy and why I'm doing this, and yeah, a little bit like supporting myself. But there's actually so much to say about the urine therapy, and I'm not so good with words. I would just suggest people, you know, if you're interested in knowing about the most wonderful thing to purify your body, to really attain perfect health, happiness, to live the life that you have ever wished to have, to create, it starts with a pure body, right? It starts with feeling good about yourself, feeling healthy, feeling happy. And for me, urine therapy is the best way to reach to that state where you are so pure, your body is so like crystal clear, that your thoughts, your feelings and your actions become one and they are aligned with your spirit. And as a consequence of this, perfect health occurs, a perfect life actually, and a perfect state of happiness and bliss. And this is why I love doing this, and this is also my purpose in going now, diving deep into this therapy, which is starting this fast. For me, is the best way to attain very powerful and fast results, and the quickest way possible, the quickest time, being effective in purifying the body. And so this is why I'm doing it, and I highly recommend for the ones that I have curiosity to know about this in depth to read the book. There are thousands of books out there about urine therapy, but the one I really loved the most and was the first one I read is the book of John Armstrong, The Water of Life. And it's a very short book, very easy to read, and you can finish it in a couple of hours. And that's all you need basically to start it, or all that I needed to start. And I also began this with a very skeptic mind. I was thinking like, what the hell? I'm gonna drink my urine? But I was open-minded enough to at least take a look about, you know what this is all about. So going back to reporting what has happened in this second day of my urine fast, I actually made a lot of notes that I'm having in front of me, and it's I'm all over the place now. I don't know where to start. Well, yeah, one very important thing I wanted to mention is thank you so much for all your support, for all your loving comments, especially to the most wonderful group on Facebook. That I also want to communicate to everyone. There is this wonderful group of people, so loving, so wise, so awakened and generous with sharing their experiences with the urine therapy and with distilled waters. And I love you all so much. You are really my family. I feel like I found my family and my soul family. We think the same. Before I thought I'm the only one crazy in this world, and the way I see the world is also so different from my environment, from my family, my friends. And now I see this wonderful work that is actually thanks to the energy and the essence of Andrew Norton Weber, who is an amazing guy. Andrew, you're really You're really amazing. You put up this group together, and with the help of your friends, of Donnie, and so many wonderful people there. Oh my, Che, Anita, Kitty, Roman, sorry, I cannot mention you all, Rosalind, and Dave Murphy. Oh, you have such a wonderful book that I also want to put it out there. I will send you the links of the urine therapy or distilled waters group on Facebook, so you can go check it out, check out the amazing array of information that is there and love that is shared there, and really is the only reason why I'm still on Facebook. It's because of you guys, and you are also the reason why I'm finally sharing all my stories. Finally finding the courage to speak out. And it has been also an impulse of my spirit to really do it now. And because we are one, you are also part of my spirit. This is the way I'm helping myself. We are all helping together. I have this beautiful image in my mind that we are all taking each other's hands and walking each other home. And it's really, truly how I see it, and it makes me very happy. So going now to, I wanted to mention Dave Murphy and his latest book, and I think it's really wonderful. I want to send you also the link to his book. It's basically a manual to become the superhuman that you are, to really know in depth who you are, how your body functions, how to heal yourself, how to attain your infinite potential, and gives wonderful examples of people who have done it and his own experience. It's really a book that I believe should be in the bookshelves of every person, of every house. And I'm also looking so much further to read the book of Andrew Norton Weber. Yeah, he's finally writing his book, and I am totally sure it's gonna be phenomenal. Yeah, Andrew, and you deserve it, Andrew, because you have been so generous with all your information. There are tons of interviews with Andrew on YouTube that you can look up, where you get all this information for free and totally from his heart, totally generous, and it will motivate everyone like it motivated me so much. Thank you, Andrew. You motivated me to really dive deep in this journey of becoming pure, becoming my best version of myself. And I'm eternally thankful to you and to all of you wonderful people. And now I can go into talking about how the second day of my fast has been. Well, you see, I'm really happy. I'm doing wonderful, really. I'm having this very exciting state of joy. At some moments it has been difficult, like I have felt the emptiness in my stomach, but they were really fleeting moments. And I noticed that it's important also for me to work with my mind and not let me, you know, seduced by these old patterns of thoughts or memories or belief system, and just start creating my new belief system, my new thoughts, following really what is true. And what is true for me is the light of my spirit, the light of my spirit that has everything already, that doesn't need any food, doesn't need any, not even urine, doesn't need anything, but it only wants us to become pure so it can shine through our bodies, this body suit that we are wearing, right? Because I see us like wearing different costumes. Some might like fancier costumes, some more simple kind of dress. But underlining this, underneath this, we are all the same. We are really one. I don't see myself being different than you or separate than you. I see you as another possible version of me, and we are just this same light expanded into tiny, tiny divine sparks that are wearing these different costumes and suits, so it can experience different scenarios, different creations, allowing you to also apply your free will and hopefully remember who you are underneath this suit, right? And this is what a urine fast does or did for me and is doing for me, is bringing me in a state of such clarity, of such purity, that I can really feel this light and I can know who I truly am, and I can experience this. And this translates into states of joy, states of not feeling hunger, not feeling the need for anything. What I did today, I woke up in the morning, I noticed that I was feeling weak. I started feeling weak and also had heart palpitations. Also a slight headache, and I didn't like that. So I thought, oh, I'm gonna do my rubbings with old urine, my massage. So I went to the bathroom, I prepared. Oh, it's working again. where was I saying this? Yeah. The only thing we really need to do is unblock the pathways for the energy to flow naturally. And this is what I did when I woke up from bed and I started doing something. It shaked me. It's like, freeing also the moving the obstacles and helping my body like that to get rid of them. So starting movement. And then all of a sudden I noticed that, wow, my headaches are gone. I'm not anymore feeling weak. I actually feel like going on and doing something, which might have been also have something to do with the fact that I drank 2 glasses of urine, my morning urine. But this was a little bit of the first revelation I was having, because I had a reconfirmation of this fact later. So I did my rubbings at my massage. I felt wonderful. My headaches were completely gone afterwards. I also did enemas. And this time I used distilled water for the enemas. And boy, I have to say, it's such a huge difference. Wow, I really didn't think it would be so significantly different. I could hold the water in me for endless time if I wanted, whereas yesterday when I used tap water, it went inside and immediately I felt like expelling it. I thought this was normal, but no. It's because my body identified the impurities of the water and it was not really doing it well. So now I'm thankful that I had this experience, because I know the difference and I can tell the difference as well. And distilled water, 100%, only distilled water now will go in me and on me, and that's the only water I will use. And I mixed it with aged urine as well. Just a little bit, not much, maybe a percentage of 10 or 20% of the aged urine, because otherwise I felt it too strong. But like that, it was fine. So I felt wonderful after this session. It lasted for about an hour or an hour and a half. Then I was feeling good. I went back to bed just to, you know, check on my emails and stuff. And since I was in bed, I felt, I want to sleep. I feel like again tired. But this was part of the revelation, I'm going to tell you, because I slept. And of course, it's okay to sleep if you feel tired. But then I had people calling me on my phone and waking me up. And I was like, damn, let me sleep. Oh, why did I forget to put my iPhone on silent, right? And this urged me to wake up, and one of the phone calls, I had to do something, right? They were asked, please, can you check there if I have this there? I left it at your place. Please, it's important. Can you check for me? And I was like, oh my God, I have to wake up, or get up now and do, and I'm feeling so weak. But I was like, yeah, of course I can do that. So it pushed me to get up and go and find this thing and search for it, which was on the top of a cabinet. And I found it, and I, okay, it's here. Yeah, I will leave it here. Then I hang up and I realized, wow, I'm actually feeling good after having done this movement. So this was the confirmation of this revelation I was having in the morning, that movement is good during a fast. I should not be afraid, conditioned by actually my old memories that, oh, I'm not having any food, so my belief system is like, I will be weak and I have to save my energy. No, this is an old, from the old world, from the old patterns. I am energy, I am light, I am infinite energy. This body is a free energy device, actually, and it's run by the energy of my spirit. And it's important that I also start changing my belief patterns, my thinking, and recognizing this truth, because it is a truth. I was up against my unwillingness, and I experienced, wow, again, this device started functioning. I compared it to, I had a vision of this new free energy devices. You probably have seen some of them, which consist of, you have to first begin a little spinning, and that's the only real mechanism that you have to push or invest some of your energy. But once it starts spinning, then it automatically clicks, and by itself it starts going on, and even faster and faster and faster and faster. You don't have to do anything else, you just have to do the first push, the first step. Yeah, this is what I experienced. And the second revelation, I was so grateful, was that even though I was alone in my place, and I could feel like, now I'm doing this all this by myself, there is no assistance, or there is no person that knows about this to guide me in case I need something. You see, assistance came. The perfect moment it was needed, and I was ready for it, and it came with the best advice in the form of a phone call. Right? I have to thank this phone call, that it woke me up, that it pushed me even to go out, get up and do something so I could benefit from it. That was my assistance. So we are not alone. I'm not alone. We are supported by the whole universe all the time. We are never alone. We're truly one with everything and everyone. And this was the second revelation. And even though I know this in theory, and I have, there is no doubt in me of this oneness and this communication, this was such a wonderful way of life to prove it to me, to show it to me. And yeah, I'm feeling wonderful because I feel so connected with everyone and everything. And I have to say, this day has been really surprisingly easy for me. I have even seen food and people preparing food and eating, which is really wonderful food that I would love normally to eat. And I felt happy for them and happy for myself. Very content. Yeah, that's the word. I'm feeling very content. And I know many more wonderful things are going to come, and probably I forgot some of them, but I think sharing these two revelations is the most important part, and that I have been kept drinking all my urine. I don't have any headaches now. I don't have any ill feeling, and the diarrhea has continued. So my cleansing is continuing through just drinking my urine. But I am supporting with massage, this is very important. I feel wonderful after them. Whole body massage from head to toe. And also after doing the massage, before I take a shower, I do the enemas. And this I did 2 times. And I'm thinking of maybe doing a 3rd time before going to sleep now. And yeah, that's it. And thank you so much. And I'm really happy for being documenting this now. And I'm sorry, it's been such a long video now, but I'll try to keep it shorter next time. Bye bye. Love you all. Bye.
I'm sorry.
Sorry for penis.
Sorry for penis. Serotonin,
melatonin. You have to keep this here.
Yeah, I stand okay.
Verdammt doch mal! Du nervst mich, du gehst mir um den Sack.
You don't even have a sack. Du hättest wieder funny, ja? Yeah? Ja, very funny, okay. Okay, so here's your story from the beginning.
Okay. It's already recording?
You see.
Okay. Okay!
Okay, you guys!
Okay, you guys! Infinite P.
Stop it now! Be okay. Professional!
Okay. I'm not professional.
You are.
I don't want to be professional.
You are.
I hate professionals.
Stop now.
Okay. Too shy.
Can you start? Yeah. Your hair looks beautiful.
Does it?
Yes.
I didn't check. Does it look beautiful?
Yes, it's fantastic. It's the only thing that matters, actually.
Yes.
And it's all there.
No. But yes. No. Okay. I am me.
Okay.
Okay. Too shy. Okay.